Yo, what's up, guys? I'm surfing Isaiah. So, one time, I was riding this super gnarly wave, and I was about to hit this insane trick. Like, it was about to be crazy. And some guy cut me off right before, and I was just fuming. So, I just looked at this guy. I was like, bruh, I don't even love you anymore. I don't even want to see your face ever again. And so, I really hope that I learned something this week. Shaka.
What is up, Southwest kids? Welcome back. My name is Kenna.
My name is Jocelyn.
That's right, you are Kenna. Okay, anyway, well, I'm Dalton. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. How are you?
Oh,
were you talking to the kids?
Sure, it's both. Sure, I'll ask.
How are you?
You took
a really long time to get here today.
I took a really long time to get here?
Yeah, you were late.
Yes, a bank got robbed. So.
Did you do the robbing?
No, I didn't do the robbing. Do you think that I would have the roads closed if I did the robbing? I would have gone through the sewers and then I would have just taken all of it.
Through the sewers?
Yeah, you gotta go
like
up
Spider-Man?
Through the sewers. What comics do you read, anyway?
Spider-Man goes in the sewers.
He goes in the sewers to fight the lizard, not to
rob
a bank.
Exactly, but he still uses the sewers just like you would use the sewers.
No. You ready? When's the first time that Spider-Man went in a sewer?
I don't know.
He went in to get the vulture because the vulture swooped in and he swooped up to steal diamonds and then he left.
Moving on from Spider-Man.
Okay.
The theme of the month this month is what you do today can change the world around you. Just like Spider-Man changed the world around him.
That's very true. J. Jonah Jameson hates his guts.
Anywho, what's the theme of the week?
Oh, the theme of the week? Love others because God loves you.
Yes, and the Bible verse that goes along with that is Galatians 5, 22 through 23 that says, the fruit the Holy Spirit produces is love, joy, and peace. It is being patient, kind, and good. It is being faithful and gentle and having control of oneself. You know what we are going to test in our game today?
What are we going to test?
The lack of self-control.
The lack of self-control? Ooh.
Or whether you have
a guess. We have a tray of cookies here?
No, we have a ping pong ball.
Oh. Why? How is this supposed to test my self-control?
I don't really know how to play. We need the voice up above in
the
sky.
Wait, no. Get on the other side. We just whack it.
Oh. I don't think that's what we're supposed to do. Anywho, voice in the sky. Where are you at?
Where is he at?
You need to sing. You haven't sang yet. You need to sing. The
didgeridoo. Okay, we gotta.
Can you come over here so they can see you? There you go.
Okay. Gotta feel it out.
Voice in the sky?
Okay, so our game today is called
you got it.
Ping Pong Filet. Ping Pong
Ping Pong what?
Filet, like Filet-O-Fish.
Okay.
Filet steak. Filet.
Don't put it in your mouth.
Well, you said filet.
No, we have not even figured out what we're doing it with yet.
Uh-huh. You're gonna do the hand thing where it sits on the table.
Okay.
And you're gonna put your hand on it. And you're gonna rotate, and if you pick it up, and somebody puts their... Oh. Can you explain it? Actually, I really don't understand this
game,
to be honest.
Yeah, so what we're gonna do, are you ready?
Oh, okay.
You are going... It's hard with this. You're gonna touch the ball like this. Gently. Fast. Okay, you go, I go.
I have cats. Oh. I have a cat. I can do like...
The hard part is it moves, so we have to figure it out. But what you can do is you can grab the ball, and if the other person hits the table, then they lose a point. Are you ready?
Okay.
Okay. Touch it. Like that. Get it?
Yeah, I get it. I guess I...
This is hard because it moves. Yeah. Do we have a buzzer?
I don't think either.
Let's try with
lost.
This.
Neither of us have lost.
Until next week, Southwest kids, enjoy the rest of service.
What is up, Southwest kids? Welcome back to the best part of service, which is worship, okay? So open up those hearts, get your jazz hands ready, because we're singing I'm Following Jesus, okay? I'm following Jesus.
On the life, there are two ways to go. You can choose abundant life, or say whatever, dude, we'll see how it goes. Now I don't know about you, I just know about me, and I know what to do. If I wanna be free, I'm following Jesus, Jesus, I'm following Jesus, Jesus. Down the road we go, it's really rather odd. We can play it safe and slow, or fly through life with God. Oh! I don't know about you, and everyone's going that way. I just wanna be free, so I'm gonna walk by faith. I'm following Jesus, Jesus, I'm following Jesus, Jesus, I'm following Jesus, Jesus, I'm following Jesus, Jesus. Lord, you made me unique, and I don't want to do what everybody else is doing. I want your word, your joy, your plan for me. I'm following Jesus, 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 I'm following Jesus, Jesus, I'm following Jesus, Jesus, I'm following Jesus, Jesus, I'm following Jesus.
What is up, Southwest kids? Welcome back to the most important part of service. Now, I don't know if you guys can smell that, but I can smell it, which means Dalton must be in the building, and Dalton is giving the message. So open up your hearts, open up your ears, and take some notes, because he's bringing it.
Why, hello, Southwest kids. Today we have our story coming to us straight from the Bible, believe it or not, I know. But, I'm just kidding, that's a joke. But what happens is we're going to start way back in the beginning, because that's a very good place to start. Now, we're up in a full, whole new month now, and we've talking about the fruits of the Spirit. So there's love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. And there's all those different ones. I don't know if we're going to talk about all of them, but we're definitely going to talk about a few of them. So first up, we're going to talk about love. Love is great. Love is kind. Love is gentle. There's all these different things that love is. But here's the thing. When is love first, like, talked about in the Bible? And how do we know? Because our bottom line today is that God loves us, okay? God loves us very, very much. But how do we know that? And here's what we're going to go talk about. So, in the beginning, there wasn't anything around, and God created everything. Boom! He goes and creates everything. He creates the trees, the plants, all the different things, the different animals. He makes sure that the sky and the water are different. He makes sure that molecules and atoms and everything aren't mixed up together and they actually have their own space. And then he makes people. And he goes and makes people, and they're wonderful because he says that they're made in his own image. So if you look around at somebody else, like your mom or your dad or your sister and your cousin or anybody, they're made in the image of God. Even you are made in the image of God, which is amazing. But here's the thing. So I can take out my iPhone here and I can ask Siri anything. I can ask her a lot of different things. But here's the thing, Siri isn't actually alive, so she's not able to make her own decisions. So if I were to go, Siri, I love you, and she can't actually say it back and mean it. So what God wanted from people was that he wanted a relationship with people. So he didn't want people to be like robots that just He wanted people to actually be living, breathing things that can make their own decisions. So, what happens is that God loved everybody so stinking much that he gave us the ability to not say I love you back, or to say I love you back. So, What happens is God creates Adam and then he creates Eve and they're both together in the Garden of Eden and it's both amazing and great and all this amazing stuff is there for them to take care of, for them to eat and all this stuff. And God just goes, hey, you're not supposed to eat one tree. You're not supposed to eat any fruit from one tree, okay? And Adam and Eve are like, okay. And then they get tempted and then they eat the fruit and then they have the knowledge of good, eating evil, and a lot of different stuff happens, which leads us to today. I know. And there's a lot of bad stuff in the world from that. But God still let them make the choice because he wanted people who would love him back. He didn't just want people who would sit there and just go, yeah, you're amazing. You're great. Your stuff. He gives everybody the option to go, hey, I love you too. But that's where it first started and why, how God first showed his love to us. But then, moving along, in order to save us from our sins, so when people turned away from God, we can't be in God's presence. We can't be in God's presence. So, in order to bring us back to that, or give people the option to come back to that, because there are some people, believe it or not, who don't want that. But, in order for him to come back, for us to come back, God had a plan. So what God's plan is first off, we have to go through all the different parts of the Bible. Because it's referenced all throughout. Even when people first sin against God, it's mentioned that there's going to be somebody who's going to come back and it's going to save us. Because it says, so the devil thinks that he's gotten away with things, and God goes, hey, there's going to be a son of man who comes back, who comes up, and you're going to bite at his heel, but he's going to stomp on your head, and he's going to eliminate you. And so he's talking about the fact that Jesus is going to come, and he's going to save all of us from our sins so that we can have a full relationship with God. But moving on past that, we go through the flood of Noah, and then we go through Tower of Babel, and then we get all the way to Abraham. And Abraham, first off, his name isn't Abraham yet. His name's Abram. He later gets named Abraham by God. But Abraham gets led to the promised land by God, and he lives there, and then he goes off and he has a son, amazingly, and he names him Isaac. And then Isaac has a son, well, two sons named Jacob and Esau. We will follow Jacob, because Jacob's the one that goes off and he has 12 different children. I know, that's a lot of kids. But then he goes on off, and those found the different tribes of Israel. So they go all the way back to Egypt, and then Moses takes them back out of Egypt because God tells them to, and then they go back on to Israel, and Joshua leads them into Israel. And then we go all the way through the books of Judges. The books of Judges are really cool. I hope that you read them sometime, but right now we don't have time to cover them here. But you got Samson, you have all these different guys, and then, and women. Deborah was in there too. Deborah was pretty sweet. But what you go through, all these different things, and then you get through Ruth. And then you go through Ruth and you get to King David. And King David talks about all these different amazing things that God has done. And God shows different things through what David does. And it's amazing. And they have prophets at this time and all this different stuff. And all this time, God keeps bringing back the fact of, hey, there's going to be somebody who's coming to save you. Don't worry about it. He's coming at some point. And then we go all through these different things. And the people of Israel keep turning to God and turning away from God. And turning to God and turning away from God. And turning to God and turning away from God. And it gets all very, very tiring. So what happens is that when they finally turn away from God, God's like, listen, if you keep doing this, you can't keep doing this. But if you keep doing this, I'm going to have people come in and invade the land and they're going to take you away. And what do the Israelites do? Okay. And they turn away from God. And God has it to where people come and invade Israel and they take them away, and that leads to the years of captivity, called the years of captivity, or exile. So, they take them all away, and the Israelites are literally living as slaves, servants, citizens of different kingdoms. And all the while, even in these times where people are like, hey, we don't know what God's doing, God's still like, hey, there's somebody who's gonna come save you. He's on his way. You guys got to be ready for him. And all of these things are being said by the prophets. And people don't believe them. And then, one day, the Israelites are allowed to come back into Israel. After quite a few years. It's been a very long time. But they're allowed to come back to Israel. And then, Alexander the Great happens. And then, the Romans happen. And the Romans happen, and this is a very big start for us because this is getting closer and closer to the point where God's promised Savior is going to come. So, God's Savior comes when the Romans are in town, and none of the people of Israel believe. I mean, some of them believe, but the majority of the people of Israel don't believe. And they hate him, and they crucify him, and they put him up on the cross. He dies for our sins, and then 3 days later, he raises from the dead. Now, that might seem very sad, but the thing is that throughout all of the different spans of history that I talked about, God always mentions that there's going to be a guy. There's going to be a land that's given for you, and he's going to be given for your sins. That's Jesus. There's going to be this guy that comes up. He's supposed to be received warmly by the people. The people are supposed to love him, but they're going to hate him. That's Jesus. There's going to be this guy that comes on, and he's going to heal all these different people. That's Jesus. Jesus is mentioned throughout all these different parts in the Bible. He even has a few cameos. But what happens is all of this stuff is finally fulfilled, and people are able to have a full relationship with God again. And it's amazing, and he sends the Holy Spirit to be with people who believe in him. And the thing is that it even says in the Bible, it's not that we loved God. There were times where people hated God. People hated God sometimes. But it's not that we loved God, it's that God loved us first. God loved us and he sent his son to save us. See, it's through God's love that we came to be saved. Okay? It's through God's love that we came to be saved. And also, Jesus is talking to his disciples one day, and all of his disciples are talking about, like, what is love? What is love? Don't hurt me. But anyway, so Jesus is going through, and he goes, no, there's no greater love than this. There's no greater love than this than for somebody to lay down his own life for his friends. And the thing is that even in that moment, when people hated God and they were turning away from God, and there were some people that like loved God, and there were some people who didn't know what to do with God and all these different things, but in the end, we were all separated from him. But even when we were all separated from him and people didn't like him very much, he still loved us enough to go, hey, you guys are still my friends. I still want to save you. Because Jesus laid down his life for people that shouldn't be called friends, but we are his friends because he calls us that. I know, that's something to think about. But, so he laid down his life for that, and he's saying that it is good, there's no greater act of love than to lay one's life down for his friends, but he's also going to talk about what he does on the cross. And so, that brings in this whole circle of different things, because there's a lot of stuff that happens in the Bible. And in the end, when everything's done, God's still going to take care of us. There's going to be things that are taken care of. Like, there's going to be things now, like I personally have a friend where he just left. He wasn't very nice to me and he just left. I might not see him again, but in the end, I know that at some point, God's going to take care of it. So, even sometimes things are going to take a very long time, but God's still in control and he loves us very, very much. He loves us so stinking much that he would die on the cross for our sins and he'd raise up again from the dead and he'd allow us to do it too so that we could be with him. And he's not just gonna leave people because his promises are always true. He doesn't go back on his promises. And if sometimes people are like, I really hate this guy, I wish that something would happen to him, and God's like, no, that's not gonna happen. So you just need to calm down because God's gonna take care of it. But with that being said, we're just talking about how much God loves us. And we ought to love one another the same way. And it's very hard to like people. There are some people that you don't like and some people that you have to love from a distance. But you still aren't terrible to them. Because that's in the Bible too. It's called the Golden Rule. Treat others the way that you want to be treated. And I would personally love for people to love me. But there's also different types of love. Like some people like to get hugged. Some people don't like to get hugged. Some people like talking about how much they love each other, and some people don't like talking about how much they love each other. So there's different ways that people love each other. And God knows about all these different ways that people love each other. But what's important is that we try to love one another. So it means being patient. Because the Apostle Paul, he talks about love, and he goes, love is patient, love is kind, love is forgiving. So there's a lot of different things that are hard about it, but it's a walk with God. It's not a sprint, it's a walk. So it's taking time, and it's just going through all these different things. And you could even just talk to God. He loves to have people talk to him. And sometimes he talks back, sometimes he doesn't. He has different ways of talking. But what's important is that he does respond. He does do that. Okay? But it's just important to him that we do try to love each other. Because if it's not taken care of now, it's going to be taken care of later. But he wants us to do that. Okay. So with that being said, let us pray. Let us pray. But anyway, let us pray. Dear Lord, thank you very much for this day, and thank you that we got to learn about you and how much you love us so stinking much. And please help us to love you in the same way. And Lord, please bless all the young men and women who are watching this and all the parents who are watching this. And, well, please help us to love one another the way that you loved us, Lord Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, thank you very much for watching.
What is up, kids? Welcome back to my favorite part of service, which is worship. Okay, in this one, we're doing walking on water, okay? We're gonna moonwalk across the water, all right? So let's get it on.
I'd rather slip walking on water than spend my life wondering what if. Lord, if it's you, tell me to come. Contain the wildest wind. I know I can make it, 'cause it was your voice that I heard. So I'm stepping out, I'm stepping out on your word. This is how you walk on water, one foot in front of the other. Never gonna let you go under, just put one foot in front of the other. Okay. I got a faith deeper than feelings, 'cause I know a name that's greater than this storm. I got a God who never ever fails me. He's close enough to catch me if I fall. Can make it, 'cause it was your voice that I heard. So I'm stepping out on your word. This is how you walk on water. One foot,
come on, show it. Stepping out on your word. I'm 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 stepping out, stepping out, stepping out. I'm stepping out, stepping out, stepping out.
Welcome back. I can't believe that I treated that man so badly. Today I learned that Jesus, we should love others because Jesus loved us first. I think I gotta see that guy, go try and see him again just because I really just wanted to go say sorry. So while I'm doing that, you guys stick around for next week. Later.